Good evening. I'm Jim Williams. We begin with that Bensonville police officer shot over the weekend. He is a father and a police department veteran. Tonight, he's on a ventilator. CBS2's Stephen Graves talked to the officer's family and heard from the family of the accused shooter. Stephen?
Yeah, Jim, loved ones of Officer Stephen Kotluski, well, they're emotional, just holding out hope for recovery, while the family of that suspect saying tonight that there's more to the story. Tonight, 21-year-old Keontae Tyler denied bail as prosecutors lay out a case of how they say he shot and almost killed Bensonville police officer Stephen Kotluski. The 12-year veteran officer hit 8 times as he responded for a domestic-related call to this apartment complex at York and Wood Saturday morning. Prosecutors say Tyler fired 10 times as Kotluski stood in the doorway, the officer's gun still holstered, as he later crawled to safety in the stairwell. Tyler would eventually surrender to police. Kotluski now left to battle extensive injuries to his legs.
This is a very difficult time. No one was expecting this to happen.
The officer's family tells a spokesperson Kotluski loved his job. He even received a life-saving award 2 years ago. Loved ones now looking to help raise money for him and his stay-at-home wife, also 3 young kids, one of whom has special needs.
They're arranging for care for the kids, feeding of the kids, taking them to school so his wife can be at his bedside.
A different type of support and outcry coming from the suspect's family today as well. A woman identifying herself as Tyler's mom spoke on Facebook Live outside the complex. She says she called police to the apartment that morning because her son was not acting like himself.
Someone gave my son a phone. They gave him some bad stuff.
You think it's drugs?
Yeah. I noticed it within a couple of days when, like I say, he was looking different.
Prosecutors say police recovered a 9mm pistol and shell casings. And while Kotluski has undergone multiple surgeries to repair his pelvis and organs, his stay in the ICU still ongoing.
Well, he's a fighter.
Kotluski is back in surgery tomorrow. Tyler, meanwhile, faces multiple felony charges, including attempted first-degree murder and aggravated battery. Live in the Streetside studio, Stephen Graves, CBS 2 News. Jim.
Stephen, thank you.